Okay, so in this session, so let's observe this, how to work with environmental locking with example. So let me open the process. This is the process which we created to show you what all the actions we have in environmental locking, right? So these are the three actions: acquire, query, and release lock. Okay, so what we'll do is here, when we are working with this particular process, environmental locking, let's take a collection. So here our collection is your shared resource. We'll use this collection as a shared resource. We create this collection is a salary details, and the field name will be salary. It will be number, and then we have some different values, and let's create some values here. So these are the, assume that employee salaries in a some salary collection. Okay. Now our requirement is we need to calculate total salary for this particular thing. For this particular collection, we are going to calculate total salary. This is our shared resource. Okay. So let's create a total salary here first. So then we will see how to work with this shared resource by using environmental locking concept. To calculate total salary, this is a collection. What we have to use? Collection means we are going to use loop. Loop start and loop end will be there. In a loop start, we are going to use collection name. Okay. Then we need to calculate. So we required calculation shape. Okay, here what we are calculating, total salary. Total salary has to be stored in some data item. So use data item to store total salary. Let's say total salary. And this data type will be number. Initial value, let's take it as a 0 for the calculation purpose. Now, double click on this. Here we required an expression. Expression will be like this: salary plus total salary, right? Total salary, where we are going to store in total salary. This is our expression. So to calculate total salary. Now, when we are running this process, what it will do, how many records we have there in this particular collection, those many number of times it will go to this collection and it will take the each and every record, and then it will calculate total salary, right? Here our requirement is, when this process is using this collection, this shared resource, another process should not use. So this is our requirement, right? So how to implement this? We will see. See this, still it is using this collection. So till 24, how many records we have? 14 records, right? 14 records until it complete, it will still accessing this collection. When it is accessing this collection, another process should not use. For that, we are going to use environmental locking concept. Here first, what we need to check is query lock, whether the lock is available or not. One more thing here, when we are working with environmental locking, always we are going to use same lock name for different process. Remember this, lock name will be the same. Lock name will be same. Okay. Now, let's observe this, how to work with this. Let me pull it down. Okay. Let it be. So first we are going to use query lock to check whether the lock is available or not, right? See this, when we are using query lock here, so this one is query lock. Nothing but checking whether the lock is available or not. What it is asking? See this lock name, and then output lock held or not. It is a true or false. Okay. First, we need a lock name. Have you created a lock here? Lock name? No, right? Let's create a lock name for this process. In a take a data item, double click on data item. This is lock, and then data type will be, let's take it as a text. Anything is fine. Anything you can give. Locked. Okay. This is our lock, right? This is our lock name. The same lock we are going to use. What is our lock name here? Lock, right? So when it is available, what this action will do is it will give lock held or not as a true or false. If it is available, when the lock is available, then it will give lock held will be true. See this here, lock held. This is another action. Lock held. It will contain true or false. This is another data item. It will contain true or false based on the lock. Okay. When the lock is available, then it should not go to the process. It has to wait until lock release, right? So where we are going to check that? In a decision. In a decision, we are going to check whether lock is available or not. What is the lock here? Flag, lock held. If it is true, then it should not check. It should not go and continue the process. For that, what we are going to do is, we are going to use the anchor here. Use it and use this. Observe this here. So now, if it is true, lock is true, then what it will do? It will go here and then again it will go to the query lock. It will not go. If lock is false, if lock is not available, then what it has to do? It has to create a lock. It has to create a lock. Now, so to create lock, create lock, we are going to call it as a acquire lock. Acquire lock. Now, what will be the lock name? This is the lock name. And then when the lock name is available, when it is creating, observe this, it is producing an output data item called token. This is a token number. This token number is unique for each and every process. Token number is unique for each and every process when it is creating a different lock. Lock name will be the same. This lock name will be the same, but token number will be different. It's a unique. Okay, when the lock is created, it will create a token number. So after that, once the lock is created, it is going to run the process. Right? So this is the, now let's observe this. So how this is going to be work. Now let's reset this process. We don't have any errors here. So I'm going to run this. So let me run one by one, step by step, and then step over. Now observe this, lock. What happened? Lock held false. Lock held is false. It means lock is not available here. Now next, it will go to the next process. It will create a lock, acquire lock. Observe this, token number has been created. It means this action has created this lock for this particular process. When you are during the runtime, okay, running. Now this is running. It is accessing the collection, right? During this, so when the collection is running, see this, it is accessing 12 and then 13, after that 14. So during the collection, still lock is available, right? So let me try to run one more time, the same one, set next stage. Now again, we are trying to run this step lock, observe that lock held. observe the lock held, still it is false, right? It means lock is not available, but lock is created here, right? Okay, now let's observe this. Next, see this, what happened? Lock held is true. It means the token is available. Previously it has created a lock, it didn't released. See this again, when you are running this, so it is going here only query lock, and then it is going looping. So because the lock is available, lock held is true, it has to be released, right? Then only so we can able to access this. For that, what we are going to do is we are going to implement release lock here. We'll implement release lock here. Let's see how to use that one, release lock. Just a minute. It's hanging. We need to use this action, another action, to release lock. Let me close the process. It has been hanged, and then reopen. Okay. Come to the same one, environmental locking. Okay. Now here we need to create a release lock. Use another action to release lock. Sorry. Now observe this. Action name will be environ business object environment locking. Action name will be release lock. When it is releasing lock, see this, it is asking the lock name. Lock name we will give. And then for token, token it has created, right? It is asking the token number as well. So this is the token. Then for this token, it is going to release the lock. So now you can use this for n number of process. Now, when you are running this, observe this, it is going to access everything, and then so it will, so still the lock is available. Okay, so let me refresh this, let me stomp this one and then reset. Now we don't have any lock. Now let's observe this one. So we are given the release lock. Okay. Observe this. Okay, some issue with the process it seems. So let me stop it. And then, so this is the, so process was, what it is going to do is, it is going to release the lock here. So we need to disconnect, and then we need to check again. Okay. So then, so this is the, so once it is released, so the same process when you are using in another one, so what it will do is, it is going to, when one process is accessing, another process will not use the same shared resource. So we will see that in, so next session. Okay. So the same concept. So we will use the same in another one, and then I will show you to you how to so use the environmental locking for different process. Here, so what we have also understand, we need to use a query lock first. After that, we need to use a create lock for. After that, we need to use a release lock. This is the so process. Remember this. So thank you.